the depiction of the gateway here with the sun going through it reminds me of a spot here in Sydney. But if we look through this book, within this book we have Tokyo right here, and then we have the shrine here. Now this would be the Meiji shrine, and it is surrounded by 120,000 trees. So you can see the number 12 in there, interestingly enough. So the shrine surrounded by 12, in a way, 120,000. So there may be something in that, further imagery in here, ritual practices, and then going back to the gateway here with the sun, sort of just interesting, I thought. Magical animals, just an interesting theme that permeates throughout occultism, and this is maybe beyond the scope of this book without reading through it, but the use of animals, the use of the spirit of animals, animal spirits within the ritual situation. Magic squares and cubes. Now you can see the interesting, just the interesting illustration on the cover here. Very intricate, kind of looks like the checkered floor, and in a way it looks like a light structure. Within here though, because it's interesting the cross-culture side of it, so the magic square in China, because the systems of magic pervade through the cultures, and of course they would be within the magical texts from these cultures as well. Just for a moment, as China is mentioned, well, I could mention so much about China. I was there in 2010 and I took these photos. They're mine that I took in a museum there. Beyond that, in China and around Asia, the spirits are represented there, and you would have, you know, like air spirits, asparas. Now these would be elementals and fairies and so forth that we basically see in Western culture as well. Now go figure. Whilst we're looking at these, I'll just make mention that a certain person I know who's into the occult has modified their surname to sort of suit one of these supernatural beings, if you will. Whilst the following may seem extremely fanciful, nonetheless, I will read. So Doyle quotes C.W. Leadbeater, "Elemental fairies, being one type of fairy, are the thought forms of the great beings, our angels, who are in charge of the evolution of the vegetable kingdom. When one of these great ones has a new idea connected with one of the kinds of plants or flowers which are under his charge, he often creates a thought form for the special purpose of carrying out that idea. It usually takes the form either of an etheric model of the actual flower itself, or of a little creature which hangs round the plant or the flower all through the time that the buds are forming, and gradually builds them into the shape and colour of which the angel has thought." So, and it goes on. Just briefly within this book here, Illuminations. First of all, just within the temple right here, we'll look further within, and we can see, so within the art in here, so interesting here how you have the kind of perhaps alluding over the hinge to the dome structure. Within the art here, you have the angelic angel figure right there, perhaps an air spirit in this case, an air elemental. The light beam pervades. Here you can see architectures within here, architectures of light. By the way, they're on the causal plane. With this depiction, you can see the emanation from the hand with an etheric spirit in this case. The gateway, and you will notice that they are the caryatids, the entities right here with the veil of light. An assist from an angel within, the architecture of light within, a picture of Isis right here, and you'll notice that the symbolism above the head has now been kind of lit up, if you will, representing light, in this case a portal. So from the cover, the moon temple, and you will notice the configuration here, and you would have a dome over here in a way, but you have the architecture here with the kind of orb in the center. You will see the orb in the center of many ritual spaces. Of course, this would all be, it looks like stone, a stone, but it would be a representation of light, I would suggest. Resurrection, and again, you can see a temple of light and the temple of stone and the connection there between them in this case. Wall of temple mysteries, and within this Assyrian-like drawing here, you can see the kind of light aspect being brought out within the artwork. So the secret visions are of the fifth Dalai Lama. So within these visions, there will be, you know, many variations as people go up, participants go up through the chakras. And if we go to some of the, now go to some of the images in here, and I'll just try and find some. So you can see the participants here in a magic circle with the lotus configuration, and possibly representing fire there. And that's a bit of information about it right there. Chakra, and various other sort of bits and pieces. Interesting with the chain. Rather kind of gruesome looking figure. So within these visions from the Dalai Lama, we see once again the flaming sword. And of course, you would see this represented in churches. It's kind of represented in Star Wars, so forth and so forth. And you can see a reference to this certainly within the Masonic Museum.